So I just started watching JoJo's newest video, and I can't believe this Beyblade. Let me just flip the camera real quick. Look at this. This is a custom Beyblade just for JoJo. Literally says J-O in the middle for JoJo. And just look at this. This is so cool.
Oh, man. That is heavy. Look at that. Metal teeth.
The whole thing is literally all metal, guys. That's insane, yo. That's awesome. I got a quick little story I want to tell you guys to kind of show how like excited I am about this whole like 3D printing Beyblades and how people are making completely custom ones. So back, I don't know how long ago this was. It was probably about like 6 years ago, maybe. I went to New York, and in New York, there's a store called FAO Schwartz, which isn't there anymore. It actually got closed. But when it was there, it was just like this big toy store. And when I was there, I was with my brother and like my whole family. And in the store, there was this machine where you could make your own custom like Hot Wheels car. And my brother ended up doing it. And literally you'd go through and you would pick like everything about the car, the colors, the design. And when my brother was doing it, I was like, wow, this is so, so cool. But it would be even cooler if I could do this for Beyblades, because at the time I was really into Beyblades and stuff. And I really had wished that like you could make your own custom Beyblade. And not just like customizing Beyblade parts that already exist. I mean, literally your own parts. Like in the anime, the characters have their own parts, like their own Beyblade. A lot of them that nobody else has, like nobody else has certain parts of a Beyblade. So right in the description, JoJo left Xander's page. We're gonna check this out because we gotta get one of these Beyblades. There's all these different steps I have to follow. It's totally gonna be awesome though. Here are the prices. If you're looking over all the steps, I realized that I need to do some research because I have no idea what actual spirit I want my Beyblade to have. Like if it should be a specific, you know, animal or beast or creature or whatever, I have to figure that out. So I'm gonna look up some stuff because I think I definitely want it to be some sort of a mythical creature, not like a real animal, because real animals have already been used. I think like almost all of them have already been used as Beyblades in the past, you know, whether that was Metal Fight or even the newer ones. But it seems like now they're going into more creatures with a Beyblade burst, and because, you know, they're running out of other stuff to do, like normal animals. And I don't want mine to be something that already has been made, so I have to try to come up with a really, really unique creature or mythical creature, hopefully something that's, you know, has some sort of stories behind it. So I'm gonna do some research right now on that. Okay guys, I've done a ton of research on a bunch of different mythical creatures, and I think I finally found one that I think would be really cool as a Beyblade. So the mythical creature I'm looking at right now is called a siren, and some of you guys might know what this is, some of you might not. I didn't know what it was until I saw it online. The best way to describe it would just be like an evil mermaid, basically. Part of the myth is that they would like sing to sailors and then kind of just like lure them in and then kill them, basically. So I started talking to Xander on Discord, and he's really into my design. He definitely knows what he's talking about and has a lot of ideas for my Beyblade, and he did some sketches like right away, and I'm really, really excited for this Beyblade. He's literally like the Madoka, or the guy that helped Vault when Vault's Beyblade broke in the beginning of Evolution. Because like he just knows so much about what he's talking about, and he totally like has all these he has so much insight of how to design a Beyblade, and it's just really, really cool. And he was very open for what design I wanted, and different, if I wanted to change something, he'd change it. And I wanted to do this gimmick for my Beyblade where it would like whistle or make a noise when it's spinning, because you know, sirens sing, so I kind of thought that would be cool. Xander really couldn't get a design that would really work, but I appreciate him like trying to make something work. And he ended up just giving me a free frame because he felt bad, which he didn't really have to do, but it was nice that he did that. We were hoping the frame would whistle, but it also didn't really work because I tested it out quite a bit with different stuff, and right, I tested it with right spin, left spin Beyblades, different drivers, and it wasn't going to make a whistling noise based on all the testing I had done with it, unfortunately.
But yeah, anyways, like, big shout out to Xander for helping with this whole thing, because without him, I wouldn't have been able to make this Beyblade. And he did a really, really good job with all the designs. He had so many good ideas. It was like, I had like the basic ideas of what I wanted, but then he like expanded on my ideas and made it into like an actual real thing. Like, I never really could think about it as like a full, I could never just picture what exactly how the Beyblade would look in my head. It was more just like I had little ideas for it, and he was able to make it into just like a whole Beyblade. So that was really cool.
Oh my god, guys, it came 3 days early. I got the package. My mom actually opened it on accident because she thought it was for her. But so that's why it's opened. I haven't looked at anything inside yet, guys. But I did just, you know, put some tape on it so you guys can't see all that stuff. So yeah, let's open this up.
Okay, so we're about to check what's inside this box. I'm super excited to see my designs come to life. Or not really my designs, more of Xander, you know. So really big shout out to Xander. Honestly, I can't thank him enough for all the work he's put into this. And I'm really excited. I really wouldn't be able to do it without him. And I just can't even explain. I just can't explain how excited I am for this. So let's just open it up. Oh my gosh, I can already start to see some of the parts. Oh my gosh, look at that. I can already see the first piece of 3D Beyblade. In here, we got another piece. Then we got the fins. Ooh, and then the green frame that he promised because he couldn't get my gimmick to work. Hopefully this will work though and make a sound or something. And then my kind of like my own level chip in a way, although it's only for my Beyblade, because it doesn't fit in other Beyblades. It's gonna be an eye, you'll see. And oh, there's one more piece in here. Here's a metal wheel. So I think it's not metal. I think the only metal piece is this one piece, which is kind of nice because if it's all metal, it will wreck drivers if you have metal teeth, which I don't think these are metal. So I think that'll be a good thing. Here's a little piece that's gonna go inside of this to make an S, because you know my Beyblade is called Piercing Siren, as most of you guys know. Good. Chip here that's gonna be making a green eye. All right, here are the fins, and I'm gonna have to glue these on, which I already have the glue. Xander recommended I use this glue to glue these on because they're not gonna be able to stay on without glue. This is how it looks now. All I got left to put on is the metal piece that's gonna go right in front of all these wings. And it's supposed to make a whistling noise, or we were gonna make a whistling gimmick for it, but obviously, like I said, it didn't work. I think I've already talked about this. So he made me a frame instead, and hopefully it's gonna whistle. No guarantee. Whoa. Phoenix frame. It's left spin, so could still spin here, possibly. No, it lost. Oh, it actually knocked out Revive Phoenix. I love it. Let's go. This is a super, super cool Beyblade. Definitely gonna be doing more testing with it because, you know, different parts will make it better, it'll probably be good against different Beyblades. And then again, I put it up against Revive Phoenix, like the number one stock Beyblade right now. So yeah, that was kind of a mega oof, but we'll see how it does when I do more testing with it. It's just like super cool though. The gimmick with the frame didn't really work, but you know, we'll do probably more testing with it. And I'm still glad because he threw that in for free because, you know, he felt bad about the gimmick not working. So that was really nice. So big shout out to Xander still for helping me throughout this whole thing. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. Check out Xander's page. I'll put it in the link, a link in the description to his WBO page if you want him to make you guys your own 3D Beyblade. So yeah, thank you guys for watching and please subscribe.